Welcome to the pre-ID student report session of the OEAA Secure Site training. Users can access a pre-ID student report to verify that students have been pre-identified to state assessments and to ensure that they are assigned to the correct content areas for each assessment. This report will include all students immediately after they have been pre-identified on the Secure Site by the district, school, or by OEAA. Let's get started. Once logged onto the OEAA Secure Site, from the menu, select Assessment Registration, Pre-ID, and then Pre-ID Student Report. Under the Search By section, you can select either Test Cycle or Test Period. A test period can, but does not always, contain multiple assessments. For example, the spring test period includes MSTEP, SAT, MyAccess, and PSAT 8. Those assessments are grouped together for accountability reasons. For this example, I will select Test Period, and then from the Test Period dropdown, I will select Spring 2019. Select the ISD and the district from the dropdown. If you do not have district-level access, you will be required to select a school, or the school may already be populated for you. For this example, I will not select a school so that we can see multiple assessments on this one report. If there are one or more assessments in the test period, or if the test cycle selected can be given either online or paper and pencil, you will be able to select a test mode from the test mode field. If selecting online, don't forget that even though the school may be administering the test online, there may be some students that are taking it on paper. I will leave it at the default of all for this demonstration. You can select content areas from the Select Content Areas box to limit the results of your report to students assigned to the test for only specific content areas. This is a good way to make sure that students that may be taking the MSTEP and MyAccess are identified to the appropriate contents and not to the same content for two different assessments. If desired, select a grade level to return students in a specific grade. If the district or school has entered reporting codes for students, then you can filter by a reporting code. What is a reporting code? Reporting codes can be used to organize students into groups by a teacher, a class, or any other group you choose. Several screens on the Secure Site can use the reporting codes to also filter the students. The big benefit of reporting codes is that the score reports and student data files can be filtered by teacher if they are set up that way. After completing your selections, click the Search button at the bottom right. There is a lot of data available on the pre-ID student report, so let's go through it. The student's demographic displayed on the pre-ID student report is updated daily from the Michigan Student Data System, also known as MSDS. This includes the student's UIC number, student ID number, student name, date of birth, gender, and ethnicity. The grade level is taken from the pre-identification record of the student. If the grade is incorrect, the student must be unassigned from the test and then assigned again to the new grade. It also includes EL, which stands for English Learner, SE, which stands for Special Education, HL, which stands for Homeless, MS, which stands for Migrant Status, HS, which stands for Homeschool, FC, which stands for Foster Care, and MC, which stands for Military Connect. Let's come back around to ED, which stands for Economically Disadvantaged. Economically disadvantaged is not a field in MSDS, but if a student receives free and reduced lunch, or is a migrant student, homeless, or has been submitted in MSDS on a direct certification report from the Department of Health and Human Services, then the student is identified as economically disadvantaged. The student demographics, if incorrect, can be updated in MSDS by your district MSDS user. Student demographics do not need to be updated daily. OEAA will do a final pull of student demographics for reporting several weeks after testing has ended, Watch the spotlight for those dates. The pre-ID date column is the date the student was initially pre-identified for the assessment. This can be helpful to identify students that were entered after the initial pre-ID date or to ensure that you have pre-identified additional new students after a certain date. There is a column for each available content area that a student could take. The columns will show the assessment that the student is pre-identified to and the mode of testing, being online or paper and pencil. Since I selected the spring 2019 test period and not a test cycle, it shows me each of the assessments in the test period that students are pre-identified for, which includes SAT, MSTEP, MyAccess, and PSAT 8. If the district or school has added reporting codes for students, the codes will display under the reporting code column by content. You can filter the columns with the column filters to make the list more manageable. For example, if you would like to review the students that are taking MyAccess, FI, and Mathematics, type in FI in the filter box at the top of the column, click on the filter icon, and select Contains. This will filter the list by the students that are pre-identified to take the MyAccess FI in Mathematics. You can filter more than one column at a time. To clear the filter, click on the filter icon and select No Filter. If you've selected to filter more than one column at a time, you can also use the Clear Filters and Sorts button at the bottom right to clear all filters. Scroll down to the bottom of the page and you will find the total pre-identified students counts. The counts are by grade, content, and mode of testing. There are two sets of print and download buttons at the bottom right of the page. The one above the total pre-ID students will allow you to print or download the student list and details. If you click on the download button, the student data displayed will download into an Excel spreadsheet. Once saved on your computer, you can add or remove columns, and it can be used for the College Board testing roster, can be created into a sign-in sheet, a verification list to ensure all paper and pencil materials are returned, and much more. The print and download button under the total pre-ID student count section will only print or download the totals. Okay, now let's switch over to the pre-ID report by a test cycle. This report is for the spring 2019 WEDA. If you filter the report by test cycle versus test period, there is one additional function from this page. You can unassign a student from the test cycle. To do that, click in the first box to the left of the student's name, and then click the unassign button at the bottom right. The student has been unassigned from the test cycle. Please note that unassigning a student from a test cycle does not remove them from accountability. On the WEDA pre-ID report, is that the barcode number is listed on the report. This is because the WEDA scoring vendor does not read the barcode labels when printed from the OEAA Secure Site. When filling out student information on an answer document that does not have a student barcode label, the school is required to put the barcode number on it. Using the pre-ID student report is an easy way to look up a barcode for one or more students. If you scroll to the bottom of the page, you will see the pre-ID counts for WEDA by grade, tier, and mode of testing. This ends the Pre-ID Student Report session for the OEAA Secure Site training. Thank you for watching, and feel free to send any questions, comments, or suggestions to mde-oeaa@michigan.gov or call 877-560-8378.